Ruenza, a te la parola come inizio. Il welcome da Ruenza.
Allora, hello, I am sorry, but my English is terrible. I would just like to greet you and tell you that it would be nice to see you directly in Romania. May success be with you and everything you do. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, but virus free. It's only in my possibility.
Yeah, we know what you mean. Thank you.
We are starting with the vax, so it's very important to see the lights at the end of the tunnel, you know.
At least it's something. So far was terrible. Okay, thank you so much, Luenza, for your words and for your wishes.
So.
And now, Daniele, you can start.
Yes.
I fade a little bit on the side, so I leave.
Okay. So you can suggest me some
Yes, of
words if
course.
I don't know very well. So I have to apologize myself for my English, which
Hi,
is
Arthur.
very,
Good morning.
very, very far to be perfect. And we have to taste together and to talk together about the wines from Romagna. And Romagna is a small sub-region or a part of the big region that is the Emilia-Romagna. But the Emilia-Romagna, as you know, until 1860, Italy was not a single nation, a single state. It was shared in different kingdoms, duchies, and states. And Emilia-Romagna in 1860 didn't exist as a region because it was divided in the different dominions. There was the duchies of Parma and Piacenza, of Reggio Emilia, and the kingdom or the duchy of the Farnese and the Estensi family, and Modena and Ferrara. And the Romagna was under the dominion of the Pope, the dominion of the state of the Pope, and was a sub-region, a part of the universe, of the constellation of the Emilia Romagna. No? And where is the Romagna? The Romagna is in, excuse me, but I have to actually. This is Italy, of course, the Emilia-Romagna region. In the southeastern part of the big region, there is the Romagna. Why the name? The name comes from Rome, of course, no? The Romagna, it comes from Rome. Because Romagna was a part of the dominion of the Pope, but not only. It was one of the part of the Eastern Roman Empire after the conquered by Justinianus in the 6th century after Christ. So, they are a part Latin, a part Greek, and the people is different from the other people of the region because of the dialect of the language that is different, and the gastronomy too is very different from the other. In Romania, there is no tortellini, for example, there is no beef. There are another tradition in gastronomy. Recipes different and the wines different. In Emilia, they produce mainly sparkling wine, the Lambrusco, of course, In Romagna, no Lambrusco. In Romagna, only normal wines, white wines, red wines, sweet wines. But three main varieties. That are two white varieties, the Trebbiano, and 15,000 hectares of Trebbiano in all the Romagna. It is not very, very, very big as a region. And so 15,000 hectares are a lot. 1,000, about 1,000 hectares of Albana, that is the other main and very native and traditional variety, and 6,500 hectares of Sangiovese, which is the big and the most important red varieties. But some information about geography, history, I think it's important to give you, because the Romagna is not very, very big as a region, of course, but is very historical, because in Romagna there are many important little cities, or not so little, but very important, like Ravenna, for example. Ravenna is the birthplace of the mosaic, Byzantine mosaic. And in Ravenna, there are many examples of that. There are many churches, many buildings in which the Byzantine people made the mosaic, the best, probably the most important mosaic of the world. And this is very important to understand, because there are a lot of culture and a lot of art in Romagna. There are many little towns, medieval little towns, like Brisighella or Modigliana. Imola is a fantastic town, for example. And the gastronomy of Romagna is very important, the same. You know that Mr. Unfortunately, in Imola, Mr. Gianluigi Morini passed over 1 week ago, was one of the most important men for the restaurateurs of Italy in the 70s, in the 80s. And Mr. Morini invented the San Domenico in Imola, for example. But Pellegrino Artusi was one of the father of the modern gastronomy in Italy in the beginning of the 20th century, for example, at the end of the 19th century. And in Romagna, the gastronomy, the wine, the hotellerie is very important. Romagna is in the middle from the sea, Adriatic Sea, Rimini and Riccione. Rimini is like our Miami Beach in Italy, because Rimini is one of the most important town for the sea holidays in our country. So very important for that, but important also for the gastronomy, for the wine. Because in the hills all around Rimini, which is on the sea, of course, there are a lot of producers, a lot of producer of wines, of course. In the south part of Romagna, there are very high hills, and the Apennines chain mountains are in the south of Romagna and divides the share of the Romagna from the Tuscany and from the Marche region. So it's very important to understand that we are in the middle of the mountains, the sea, and the flatlands that are on the north of the Romagna. After the Via Emilia, on the north of the Via Emilia, that is a very important freeway now, and was built in ancient time by the ancient Romans, and divide the hilly part of Romagna on the south from the flatland part of Romagna on the north part of the region. So it's very important for the soil and for the weather too. We are on the north of the Apennines chain mountain. And so let me say this, because I was I was professor of geography in Italian schools, so I know something about the geography of Romagna and the weather. But the Via Emilia and the Apennines in the south don't preserve, don't defend the Romagna from the northeast winds. And the northeast winds are the cold winds that comes from the central part of Europe. So in Romagna, at the same latitudes, we can have a colder weather in comparison with the weather of the other part of Italy, of the Italian peninsula. If you compare the weather of Romagna with the weather of Upper Tuscany, for example, the Tuscany is warmer than Romagna because of the Apennines that defends from the northeastern winds that fly from the Central Europe. So in Romagna in winter can snow a lot, for example, much more than in the western part of the Italian peninsula. And this is very important to understand because we are in the north part of Italy, but it's the south of the north. This is very important to understand because the wines, of course, are very different from the wines from other parts of the central Italy. We are central and northern part of Italy, the south of the north, in fact. So I told you that in Romagna they produce mainly three varieties, the Albana and Trebbiano white varieties and the Sangiovese red varieties. Sangiovese is the same that they grow in Tuscany and in the other part of central Italy, in Umbria, in Le Marche, for example. But the Sangiovese in Romagna is very important because the memories, the remembers of the Sangiovese is older than in other parts of Italy. We have testimonianze, we have news about the Sangiovese from the 17th century at least. Before the Sangiovese was very known in Tuscany, for example. And the DOC, Sangiovese di Romagna, that is from 1967, the DOC, is the first denomination with the name of Sangiovese in the denomination. If you compare with the famous Tuscan denomination, Chianti Classico or Brunello di Montalcino, they are Chianti Classico, Brunello di Montalcino, Vino Nobile di Montepulciano, no Sangiovese in the name. They produce with the Sangiovese, of course, but they there is no name of Sangiovese, no Sangiovese in the name of the denomination. And a little difference because Sangiovese and Romagna are very close and the name of Sangiovese for the red wine in Romagna is normal. It's not like in Tuscany, that is first Chianti Classico, first Brunello, first Vino Nobile. In Romagna, there is first Sangiovese, and then there is the origin of the Sangiovese. And there are many differences in Romagna Sangiovese in all the region, because there are different origin in Romagna. So, imagine a little region with a lot of faced expressions of different varieties, because the position in a particular side of Italy, in which there are some Mediterranean and southern characters and some northern characters, is a chain, is a point of contact between the north and the south, the Mediterranean and the continental weather. And this is very important because Romagna is not very known about the situation, about the expression of the wines, and this is very important to know and to understand. I think to I don't know, to give some to make curiosity for you about Romania, because it's a real interesting little region that has a lot of different expressions in gastronomy, in weather, in wines, of course. It's very important. The Consorzio Vini di Romagna is the consorzio that is like a big umbrella on all the production of Romagna. And there are many producers, a lot of little producers, a lot really of little producers. There are some great cooperatives, for example, that let thousands of little producers to make wines. And this is another character of the wines of Romagna. Little producer, big cooperatives, some medium-sized producer, and all the most important wine region in the world are made of that. Because if you go to Champagne, to Burgundy, to Lange, you have the same. You have little producer, you have cooperatives, and medium big producer that bought wines, but the I don't know the differences and the different character, the different size of the producer make richness of the expression of the wines, in my opinion. So it's very important to explain these two. That's a wine region could be composed by a different expression and different producers, and not only little producers, not only big cooperatives, but a universe, a constellation of different mm-hmm. expressions. This is important. That is common in all the main wine region of the world. So we have to taste six wines today, and two are white wines and four are Sangiovese, Romagna Sangiovese. The two white wines are from Albana. Albana takes the name from Albus, Alba, that in Latin, in ancient Latin language, means white. The name is the white grapes in ancient Latin. And we have historical news about Albana from the 13th century at least. But for example, Galla Placidia, that was the wife of Theodosius, that was an emperor in Roman times, in ancient Roman times, and named the Albana in the 4th century, so after Christ. So the Albana is a name of a grape that is very, very traditional, very historical. So it's important to understand. And Albana comes from some part of Romagna that is the part very close to the Via Emilia. Bertinoro is probably the main town for the Albana. Bertinoro means ber ti you in oro. So you have to drink it in gold. In gold, probably in a glass of gold or something like that. And Bertinoro means that, but Bertinoro could be also the Castrum Britannorum when the pilgrims came to Rome from the British Isles. They took they have to go from Britain to Italy, of course, and in some part of Central Europe they built some little towns to pass to rest, mm-hmm. in fact. And custom, Britain norm, make the place of the people that came from Britain Isles. So custom, Britain norm, Bertinoro probably is a name that can come from this origin. And Bertinoro was in the middle from the north part, the Alps and Rome. So they rest for a night, for two nights, and restart to go to Rome as pilgrims, Christian pilgrims, of course. So Bertinoro is probably the capital, and I remember that when I knew the Albana for the first time, when I was young, several years ago, the Albana of Bertinoro was the Albana, because the Albana of Bertinoro was from Bertinoro was the real Albana. The first wine we have in our selection is not from Bertinoro, it's from Marzeno. And it's the Albana produced by Fattoria Zerbina. Fattoria Zerbina is one of the most important producers for Albana, not only for Albana. But for Albana, because they make Albana, dry Albana like this, the Bianco di Ceparano 2019. And is a dry Albana, but with the Albana you can make, and they can make also sweet wines, fantastic sweet wines, because the Albana is I don't know, you know Joe Cocker. Joe Cocker was a man of Sheffield, a very white man that sang with a black voice. He's a black man that sings the blues. And that sang the blues, and unfortunately passed away. But this is the same character. Albana is a white variety, but with red character because of the tannins, because it's full of polyphenolic substances. So it's like Joe Cocker, it's like Tom Waits, it's like that. Is apparently white, in fact, is a little red. And Albana is it's possible to make also fantastic both resided Albana, for example, and Cristina Gemignani, which is the producer of Tenuta Zerbina, makes probably the most incredible sweet Albana both resided, and that is possible to have in Italy, one of the best sweet wines of Italy and probably of the world. And the Albana Scacco Matto, the Albana AR, are fantastic sweet wines. This is not a sweet wine, this is a regular dry Albana. And we can taste now. And the nose of the Albana is a nose of yellow plums, probably peaches, fruity. Fruitiness in the nose, and on the palate, like the Albana, is very salty. There is not the acidity, the character of the Albana, it's the saltiness, it's the body, it's like a red wine, because the saltiness is more important than the acidity, and this is very important to understand, because Albana is a Mediterranean touch and a white that sings the blues. This is important to understand. And I want to ask to Cristina, because he's in contact, what she thinks about the Albana, and what she thinks about the sweet Albana too, because this is a dry Albana, of course. But what you think about the capacity of the Albana to expand itself as a big sweet wine, Cristina? No, you have to switch on the your audio. It's possible to for you to
turn on.
Okay.
Can you hear me? Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
English.
And I would like to say hello to everybody and thanks to be here in spite of the very bad weather. So to be very quick to reply to Daniele, I think that it was a very a challenging experience to deal with Albana because it was first of all the first DOCG wine. When I started to work in Zerbina, we got this specific with this important recognition. So it was really a great responsibility to find an excellent way to show that Albana was really a DOCG wine. And the first experience was to try to wine make it this grape with botrytis. For one reason, because I studied in Bordeaux, so I was very, and I'm still very fond of dessert wine with botrytis. And it was interesting to see that Albana was quite neutral, but the only, for me at the time, the really positive.
Sina, let me say, I think that there are some similitudes between Albana and Semillon.
Right. Exactly, is exactly what I wanted to say, because Semillon is also wine neutral and is mostly used for Sauternes, much more than Sauvignon Blanc. And I wanted to try to create in Romagna a similar experience of Bordeaux, but the challenge was to use a local grape. We could really make it in 1987. And after 3-4 years of very deep experience and different, of course, situation of different harvest, we could realize in 92 two things, that the botrytis, of course, has to be naturally induced and not sprayed on the vines. This is the first point. The second point, that we were in a land where botrytis could really catch naturally the grape. And once the botrytis could develop in the grape, our capacity should be to select it very fresh and very quickly. This is why for dessert, we need to make different tree, different passages in the vineyard. But the experience of dessert with such a capacity of aging of the wine, this incredible clean taste and the finesse of the wine, solicited us to try also a way for the dry. And in the dry, what I might say is something that other producer don't agree with me, but I don't like too much astringency. So my feeling is that I wanted to have a very vibrant, clean, and very specific taste of this grape in the wine, but without tannins. So what we do is to create a specific vineyards from dessert, different from the dry project. In the dry project, the vines are much more close one to the other to create a sort of microclimate where the grape can, of course, ripe, but they can maintain a sort of a green color of the skins that doesn't evolve and doesn't produce a too tannic character in the winemaking. And to make this happen, we need, of course, to have the plants much more close one to the other, to sort of to protect with the leaf the grape that, of course, in any case are, of course, well, how can we say, ben arieggiate, well, right, and so they are completely healthy, of course, when we started to pick them. And the project really could work in a different way from the botrytis grape, but again, with, I think, a very personal style. So to show that Albana is possible, Albana is something that it's indigenous from our region. So for us, it's an incredible value, this one, because when we speak about Sangiovese, sometimes we have to deal with Tuscany, Marche, Umbria, but Romagna is something
Albana is only from
hours. And that's why we are really putting a lot of energies to maintain and to create a very personal style. And Bianco di Ceparano, it's a little bit the demonstration that Albana can be declined in different style.
Okay, there is there questions by Lana? I don't know. Okay, yes. So
she's wondering how close we are.
Okay, how close to see the vineyards? Marzeno is very close to Faenza, so yes, we are in. Okay, and Faenza is not very close to the sea. Bertinoro is closer to the sea. We are probably 35, 40 kilometers from the sea, 35.
Oh, okay.
From Marzeno, Faenza is 35 kilometers from the sea. Bertinoro is closer to the sea. And Bertinoro is the other Albana, I Croppi, Albana Secco. I forgot to tell you that Albana was the first white wine with the DOCG in Italy. DOCG is the super doc, the Italian super doc, and was the first white wine with the DOCG. This is very important. In 1985, 86, I don't remember well, but was the first DOCG. So the first super white in Italy, the Albana. Because of the tradition, probably, because the native grapes, because the tradition, that's all, the tradition is very important. The second Albana is an Albana from Bertinoro, the Albana that Cristina Geminiani, Fattoria Zerbina, made is not in Bertinoro, it's in Marzeno, that is close to Faenza, and but Bertinoro, we are going to the sea in Bertinoro, with soil, different soils, because it's a clayish, yellow soils, sandy, because in Bertinoro you begin to feel the seas, and probably feel the sand of Rimini, the seaside. But the Albana from Bertinoro is the Albana, the more classic Albana you can have. And the second Albana is a 2019 Croppi by Celli Vineyards and Celli Winery. And Celli Winery is one of the most important player for the Albana Secco in Romagna. There is c'è qualcuno che di Celli
Hello everybody. I am Mauro. Mauro. I am here in Bertinoro.
Let's taste together the your Albana.
I can see the sea. It's 5:00 PM, but we can see the sea.
Okay. So I Croppi 2019 is real Albana from Bertinoro. So the classic Albana. The classic Albana is a little more golden in the color, and the nose is the classic nose of the Albana with some east scents and fruity. Probably le nespole, come si chiamano?
Yellow
fruits, of course, but not only some nuts, something like almonds in the nose, and the body is very big, very salty. Is a big white wine.
Absolutely, I think that Cristina and Daniele explain very well everything
Thank
about Albana. sure, better than me, but I can add the three important elements of Albana. Albana is sensitive to floral abortion, and for that reason, sometimes we have the fruit very spare, and we can take a lot of content in sugar. But another characteristic is that the Albana preserve the acidity also with the high content in sugar. That is I think one of the most important characteristic of this kind of grape.
Mauro, try to explain the bunch of the Albana.
The bunch of Albana is normally long. We have normally two kind of Albana. The Albana that is planted traditionally in Faenza area or Imola area, that is the branch is very, very long. The Albana, Bertinoro's Albana is different, it's more compact, it's more sensitive to the botrytis. And you have to plant in the right soil. If you choose the wrong soil, you can have the problem. Of course, normally we plant the new vineyards in a soil where we have the content of calcare from 35 to 40%, very, very high. We plant also in the area that is called Fratta, where there is the blend of Spungone soil with chalk soil. The Albana need this kind of terroir to preserve very well the acidity, to have the develop of the sugar. And in our, we produce Albana since a long time. We start to produce the first Albana was produced in the 1965 when the Celli company was founded, And we produce Albana in a different style from Albana Dolce, dry Albana, Albana Spumante, and of course,
very eclectic, variety.
It's eclectic variety. We love is for a long time was the most important in our economy, also respect the Sangiovese. And I remember when I was a child, during the harvest time, to spend a lot of time to filter the Albana, to produce the Albana sweet. It's very nice. And it's also the first wine that I tested with my grandfather, breakfast time, Albana and bread. It was wonderful. Okay. Anyway,
Mauro, Lana Bortolot wrote, I had this with miso ramen last night and it was perfect. The saline quality set of the umami of the soup. So the matching of the Albana with the international cuisine, the Eastern Far Eastern cuisine, like the miso ramen, that is Japanese cuisine or Oriental cuisine. It's fantastic. And it means that Albana is eclectic also in the matching with the food. Very important, because sometimes some fantastic varietals, international varietals, like Sauvignon, for example, but they marks the organoleptic characters probably a little too much if you want to match with the food, and don't respect at all the matching. So if you have not lobster, it's difficult to match Sauvignon. Okay,
we can match Albana. You can match with a different kind of food, from lobsters to rabbit to white meat
To piadina and to piadina too.
Of course, piadina. If you are lucky with piadina, of course.
And the piadina in Romagna is like a religion, you know.
Yeah, more because we don't believe too much in God, but in piadina,
Cappelletti.
Cappelletti anche, cappellacci, different from tortellini, very different from tortellini, you know, because the inside part of the cappelletti is full of cheese and not full of meat. The real difference between Emilia and Romagna. In Emilia there is meat, in Romagna there is cheese, and Albana is perfect with that. So but we are, of course, passionate with wine, technique with wine, but the matching is wine and food is a character that, I don't know, identify the Italian way of life in wine and food. And this is very Italian to match the food and the wine, because for us it's healthy to drink and to eat together. And sometimes in other part of the world is not in the same way, but we are proud of that. This is important. Let's go in another universe. And from Albana, the red, the white and a little bit red wine, to Sangiovese, that is a big red wine, but a little white because the acidity. You know? So, and there are many expressions in Romagna about the Sangiovese. It's Sangiovese, but it's not only Sangiovese. It's Sangiovese from Imola, from Faenza, from Colli di Rimini. It's Sangiovese from Brisighella, from Predappio, from Modigliana. So the more you go to the south, the more you are in altitude, the more you go to Via Emilia, the more you go to the flatland, the more you go to the south, you have rocky and the clayish soils. The more you go to the south, you have a little more marne, limestone, and probably sand. And there are different differences. A different expression of Sangiovese, and the same for Pinot Noir in Burgundy, the same for Cabernet Sauvignon in Bordeaux, the same for the Nebbiolo in Lange. So every important wine region has different expressions due to the soil, to the weather, to the, of course, to differences, of course. And the first wine we have is 2019, so a fresh Sangiovese, Romagna Sangiovese Superiore. Superior means a little better, in fact, but means less production in the fields and a little more level of alcohol. In Italy, Superiore means that. And the same in Bordeaux. Bordeaux Superieur is the same idea of wines. So, Le Rocche Malatestiane, I Diavoli, the devils, from Terre Cevico, Le Rocche Malatestiane, and it's a wine from the eastern southern part of Romagna, close to Rimini, close to the sea, close to the hills that dominate the sea. Is a Sangiovese Superiore, but it's not so complex. But it's a very drinkable wine. It's a wine that you can match with the grilled meat, with a fantastic hamburger by Gallagher's New York. And, this is the perfect matching of this wine. We have Elena Piva from Terre Cevico.
Yes.
That explain us which kind of wines is the I Diavoli, the devils.
Yes, good morning. So I represent here Le Rocche Malatestiane, is a winery in Rimini.
Elena, Malatesta was the name of a family
that
dominates all the southern eastern part of Romagna and the northern part of Le Marche.
They was Lord, yes, Sigismondo Malatesta was Lord of Rimini in the Renaissance.
Yes.
So Malatesta is the it's name of the family.
The bad head.
Bad head, yes. And
crazy.
Yes. And we are in Rimini, so in the eastern part of Romagna, and very, very close to the sea. We are a cooperative, so we have 400 wine growers that work with us for this project about Sangiovese. And we have a very, very big area because we work with the 7,000 hectares.
Elena, I want to show the label because it's very nice, the label. And in Romania, yes, there are many producers that
I have a label too.
Okay. You know. And it's very nice. Yes. And there are many producers that put on the bottles fantastic labels. I don't know.
Yes,
why,
because you have this...
an artistic sensibility, probably.
But anyway, we put on the label, so the name is I Diavoli, that means, of course, devils. But.
Bats?
Bats, yes. Because vineyards are very close to a natural reserve where lives 6,000 bats.
Full of devils.
All the European species are in these caves. So okay. we dedicate this label to the bats. And anyway, this wine we produce this wine in a part of this big area where we work, and we are 2,000 meters above sea level, and on clay soils. So we have in this big area three different soils, and clay soils are very common in Romagna and in Rimini, of course. And we have here in this area brown clays.
Okay, so not red, not full of iron, for example.
Not gray, but brown.
Not gray,
so
not red.
Yes.
Okay.
And they give to the wine this fruity and this fruity profile. Hmm?
Yes, it's very evident because it's really fruity wine. You have, for example, il Mastino, that is more complex.
The Riserva.
Yes, mm-hmm. The Riserva. This is not Riserva. This is what it has to do, what it has to be. An example of what a Romagna Sangiovese close to the sea has to be. It's not complex, it's very drinkable, it's very fruity.
Well rounded tannins, yes, dark red, and.
But it's not so dark. It's a light red. In fact, that is the color that a Sangiovese has to be, has to have. This is important because sometimes we can find some Sangiovese very very dark colored. It's not so common for a Sangiovese. Sangiovese is not so full of anthocyanins. And the relationships between acidity and tannins are very important to understand because Sangiovese, normally the acidity is more important than the tannins. Then in Montalcino could be different, but Montalcino is another part of the world. In Romagna, the relationships between acidity and tannins are fantastic because you can find some acidity that make you salivation don't stop the salivation with this wine. So it's very, very, very positive for a matching and for the drinkability. It is important for a wine like that, in my opinion. It's a 2019. If you have no tannins that cut your tongue, it's important because the drinkability, it's that. It's the easy to drink. It's not a wine with no body or no structure. It's a wine with a lot of body, but it's not so hard to drink. And this is important because all the big wine, Mediterranean big wine, are I don't know, round with a big body, but not so hard to drink. And I diavoli is not hard to drink. And this is the best compliment I can give to this wine. But let's go on. Thank you, Elena. And
thank you.
The wine after is look at the label, because the label is fantastic. The label is the label of Noelia Ricci, that is a Sangiovese Superiore, Romagna Doc Sangiovese, Predappio. Why Predappio? Predappio, you know the MGA in Langa. And in Romagna, there are something like that. There are the sub-denomination or super-denomination, better. And the Predappio is one of the higher part of the landscape of the Romagna Sangiovese. And the first wine of this particular area of Sangiovese that is here, so not so far from the mountain that are in the south of the Romagna. We are between 300 and 500 meters on the sea level. It's a very important Sangiovese for the altitude and for the sub-denomination. And this is Noelia Ricci. The name is Godenza, the name of the wine. It's a 2018, probably a fresher vintage in comparison with 2019, and comes from Predappio. And Noelia Ricci makes probably some of the more incredible and fantastic labels of the Italian wines at all. It's a not big winery. It's from Predappio, and the character of the wine different from the I Diavoli, not only because they are one is a Sangiovese Superiore and the other is a super Sangiovese, like Predappio Sangiovese, but also because the origin is different. One is from Rimini, so close to the sea, and the second is from Predappio, that is in the middle of Romagna, in altitude, with a different character and expression of Sangiovese. Who is the representative of Noelia Ricci? Marco Cirese. Marco Cirese, explain us your wine.
Yes, good afternoon, and thank you for this opportunity. First of all, I'd like to present myself. I'm quite new to the wine world. My mother changed my life in 2008 when she decided to take over the winery. Noelia Ricci was my grandmother, and I decided to dedicate this project to her. I chose the 7 hectare in the highest part of the state, Sangiovese. I wanted to valorize the vineyard in the peak of the state, where the clay soil becomes sandy and rich in limestone and sulfur.
Which is the altitude of the vineyards?
Between 300 and 340 meters.
Okay.
So Godenza, it was a whole
house. In altitude, and it's possible to understand by the acidity of this wine. It is very evident.
Yes. I was looking for freshness and fineness. So the sandness can give me the elegance. And this is why I choose these hectares. Godenza is a single vineyard, so it's one.
It's a crew, is a grand crew of Sangiovese in Romagna.
Yes, and it's 1.5 hectares.
Aging in big barrel, Tonneau. which age?
No oak is required.
No oak.
This choice was to give freshness to the Sangiovese, and so it's vinificated in stainless steel, and then it stay 1 year in bottle.
Okay, this is a Sangiovese from a higher part of Romagna. The acidity is evident, is very drinkable at all, but less roundness in comparison with the Diavoli that was the previous. And not only because this is a single vino, but also and mainly because of the origin of the wine. One close to the sea, the second in altitude, and in a more continental situation as a weather. So this is like, I don't know, if you know the Chianti Classico, the Diavoli could be, I don't know, Castelnuovo, Berardenga, and Noelia Ricci could be Radda. So it's different for this reason, and this is a fantastic wine. I want to see you, I want to tell you, Marco Cirese, that I bought 6 bottles of your Trebbiano for my home, because I like very much your Trebbiano.
Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy.
Ecco, in the Goccetto wine bar in Rome, you know. So I paid, of course. So let's go on. And I have a very good and old friend of mine, Enrico Dreidonà, and the Notturno is another Predappio. 2018, the same vintage, but different because the wine making is a little different between Noelia Ricci and Dreidonà, if I remember right, Enrico. And so we are in Predappio the same.
We are in the same area of Predappio, but we are in the first round hill in the, we say, the lower downtown Predappio, yeah, in lower part of the sub-appellation. Our average altitude is about 160 meters. It's inside the Predappio DOC MGA. In our area, there is a sort of connection between yellow sands and the Spumone line. So there is a sort of a crossing area as a terroir and a geological.
The difference is a difference of shape of the wine, because the Noelia Ricci, the acidity is more evident. In this wine, the roundness is more evident, and the body is more evident, because you are a little bit more Mediterranean than Noelia Ricci.
Yeah, I think, I don't know exactly. Difference, small difference in the terroir, but we have an idea. We have about 38% of sands in the texture of the soil, and we always have very, very round and very full body, rich of fruit, grapes, that we need usually to have a much more longer refinement and aging than other wines around the region.
You have a little bit of wood in this wine, the oak.
Yes.
It is the other difference.
Yes, Notturno is our classical Sangiovese, so the regular Predappio DOC Sangiovese is aged for 1 year in large cask. It's 15 hectoliters and 25 hectoliters, and a part of them is also aged in the classical tonneau, second year tonneau.
There is a touch of spiciness in this wine, more than the previous. So in the previous is a fruitiness and the idea of the varietal sense of the Sangiovese. Mm-hmm. In these, there is more spiciness and more body, probably. So it's different, the origin and the winemaking in the two wines.
I think what we are looking in the Predappio MGA, we are a group of producers, we talk together many times. And there is a difference inside the MGA because we have different altitude and different situations. So from the highest side, from the lower side, we have different little, some small difference in the geological structure of the soil. And so that's reflects on the wines. So it's important. We are not still homologated, and I think also wine making style could be maybe different choice. We like wine. We always, you know, my father's style.
What is Predappio MGA? What is Predappio MGA? Let's explain, because back issue Abstain asked to what is the Predappio MGA? As in Lange, like I don't know, Abusia or Canubi or other MGA. Geographic mention addition. So it's not only Romagna Sangiovese, but it's Romagna Sangiovese in some particular areas. Excuse me. I don't know. Okay.
We cannot hear.
No, so MGA means that mention geographic addictions, and so in Romagna, as in Langa, they have some addiction, geographic addiction. So a little part of the area that are particularly important. So there is Predappio, there is Modigliana, there is Brisighella, there is Serra, there is many others. I have here, there is Castrocaro, there is Meldola, Longiano, and Bertinoro too, of course, and Oriolo, and Barzeno too, of course. And they are a little part, like I don't know, you know, the difference they have, Appellation Comunalam in Bourgogne is an idea very close to that idea in Burgundy or in Langa, with some important areas, sub areas of Barolo and Barbaresco, for example. Is the same for the Sangiovese in Romagna, and it's very important to understand, because it means that in Romagna there are a lot of different expressions due to the soil and the weather. So they wanted to focalize it, the situation, giving a different sub or super denomination in this case. In all the denomination in all the world, there are a pyramid of quality, the basic wines, the superior wines, and the cru. Imagine then in Romagna the Predappio, Modigliana, Marzeno, and Casca could be like a appellation comunale in Bourgogne or in Cordeaux, of course. So Predappio is like Gevrey-Chambertin or Volnay or I don't know, something like that, to let you understand the situation. The last wine we have to taste is a legend, because Fattoria Paradiso, I was in Fattoria Paradiso in the 80s, the first time with Mr. Luigi Veronelli. Luigi Veronelli was the most important wine writer, like Hugh Johnson in UK, or more than Parker, invented the wine critic in Italy. It was a person very, very important. And Mario Pezzi was the owner of the Fattoria Paradiso at those time. And the Vigna delle Lepri was the first, probably, in together with Rocca di Ribano, probably by Spalletti, and a few others, Sangiovese of Romagna, that has the name of the vineyard on the label. And Vigna delle Lepri was a riserva, was the most important Sangiovese riserva at those time in the 80s in Romagna. I remember, like a legend, the Vigna delle Lepri of Fattoria Paradiso. It's from Bertinoro, so the birthplace of Albana, but also an MGA, so a super denomination of Sangiovese too, not only for the Albana. And Fattoria Paradiso is one of the legend of the Sangiovese. It's a 2014. It is not probably the luckier vintage of the world, but it's not bad. The wine of Fattoria Paradiso. There is the owner, the representative of Fattoria Paradiso here. It's
Jacopo.
Yes, no. Jacopo. Where is Jacopo?
Sono qua.
Okay, so I introduced the Fattoria Paradiso as I can, but Fattoria Paradiso is a real legend, you know. Explain us what is Fattoria Paradiso. I was in Fattoria Paradiso with some friends, and one was Luigi Veronelli, and the other was the owner of a famous restaurant, Castro Caro, that you probably remember, eh?
Sì, Gianfranco Bolognesi.
Gianfranco Bolognesi, another legend.
Sì. Okay. Hi to everybody. Thank you for coming. Just one thing over Romagna first. No, it's difficult on international market to explain where is Romagna in Italy. But usually I said, in Italy, tortellini, passatelli, prosciutto di Parma, aceto balsamico.
Passatelli is from Romagna, tortellini e prosciutto di Parma, no.
No, but Emilia Romagna, I'm talking about all the region. Yeah. Parmigiano Reggiano, Ferrari, Lamborghini, Ducati. Well, everything is made in our region, so we are famous. we are a famous region. About the wines, we own, my family owns the estate since 1853, and we start the production and the sales in 1940. We have about 250 acres.
Was Mario your grandfather?
Grandfather, yes.
Grandfather,
yes.
Okay.
Yes,
I met him and your grandmother
in
1982, probably.
Yes, and my grandfather created the first Riserva of Sangiovese, the Vigna delle Lepri, in 1970. I have here a bottle. This one.
No, yes, that was a bottle. It was a Burgundy bottle. Eh?
This is the 1970, the first Riserva of Sangiovese in produced in the region, and was an idea to demonstrate that in Romagna it was possible to make a great Riserva and a great Sangiovese, great for aging, is a classic cru, is a single vineyard made in a vineyard very 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 rich of clay, with the classical Biondi Santi Clun, so is not a Sangiovese with power.
The BBS clone.
Yes. And the great crew in all the world, you can recognize the great crew, the great vineyards in the world, it's more easy to recognize them in bad vintages, in small vintages. We decided to present the 2014 vintage today because it's not a great vintage. But Sangiovese usually if you have not a problems of about disease or too much rain, etc., in small vintages you can find a very on Sangiovese a great elegance.
Okay, Jacopo, there is a difference due to the vintage, of course. 2014 is different from 2018, and for the timing, but also because you are in Bertinoro, and in Bertinoro the Sangiovese explains itself with more tannin, And you have 2014 that apparently is not a big vintage because was a rainy vintage and a rainy harvest, but the tannins in this wine are more important than the acidity. In Predappio is the opposite. So these can explain us that the Romagna and the Sangiovese can explain itself in very different way, and it depends on the origin of the wine. So this is a 2014, so rain and cold vintage, but the wine is full of tannins and full of body, the same, because you are in Bertinoro.
Yes,
and he's different.
Yes,
like I don't know, Pauillac is more important than the Margaux as body or as expression of the Cabernet Sauvignon, and Castelnuovo Berardenga is different from I don't know, from Panzano, no, and in Chianti Classico, and Il Greppo by Biondisanti is different by the Brunello that they produce in the southern part of Montalcino, in Sant'Angelo in Colle, you know, for example. So it's important to understand and to explain that Romagna can explain the differences and the character in very different ways. And for a so small region, wine region like Romagna, that is not small at all, but small in the universe of the wine regions, of course, it's important to understand that, because the nobility, the noblesse of the wine regions is due to that reasons, to the richness of expressions. And in Romagna, you have Albana that can give fantastic expressions as dry wines, especially as sweet wines. And Sangiovese, that is fantastic in different expressions. Is that what is better or what is less good? The problem is the differences. And the idea that you can have about the different origin of Sangiovese. Ora, Valentina asked very interesting this the super area, the super area. The idea of Sangiovese from Romagna, from Tuscany, but you know, in 2001, I have noticed is about 52 different clones of Sangiovese. If you cross the clones with the roots and with the soils, you have a universe of different Sangiovese. So if you say Sangiovese, it's not the definitive. You can have an idea of Sangiovese, but you have to pay attention to the origin and to the soil, to the clones, to different things. So 52 in 2001, probably now there are many more than 52. Because they selected different clones of Sangiovese nowadays. So the idea of only about the variety it's not complete if you want to understand the expressions of the different wines. Mm-hmm. I say the Sangiovese is more Romagna than Tuscany as origin, because we have historical news, historical notices about Sangiovese first in Romagna and then in Tuscany, and this is important to understand. Then io non vedo più niente qua. Then okay.
Vedi.
Then, ecco, this is the sub-region of Sangiovese in Romagna. And the more you go to the right of the figure, the more you go, the more you go to the sea, the more you go to the south part, the more you go to the mountain, the more you go to the Via Emilia, that is the yellow freeway from Cattolica to Ozzano Emilia, that is the last town in Romagna. The more you go, Ozzano Emilia is Emilia, it's not Romagna. And the more you go in another part of the world, probably. And these are all the differences by the origin of Romagna. This is another part of the map, and you have all the vineyards in Emilia, in Romagna. And you can see and you can understand how rich are the landscape of the Romagna Sangiovese. This is the Enogea. Enogea is the Enogea is made by Alessandro Masnaghetti, that is the husband of Cristina Geminiani. He's a fantastic wine critic and is a fantastic designer of map in all Italy, and this is the map of Enogea that is made by Alessandro, that is a real close friend of mine, and is a fantastic wine critic, of course. And you can understand also the situation of the vineyards in all the area of Romagna. So you can have an idea of the richness of expressions. And this is very important to understand, because Romagna is not only a name, it's a situation, a pedoclimatic and a different, very rich situation in our wine regions in Italy, and in this case, in a particular area. It probably is not very known. And this is a shame, because Romagna is a very rich of history, very rich of gastronomical expression and of wine expressions. And this is very important to know. Yes, we can close the map. And I think could be interesting to see and to understand that. So, I have
some questions from
if you have some questions, guests. Of course, I'm here and the producer are here. I'm finishing my speech. I have to apologize. Excuse me. In the cellar are not indicated in the three sub-regions of Rimini, because they are approving now
in the process,
but some bureaucratic reasons, of course. But this means that they are selecting more sub-areas in Romagna to demonstrate that in Romagna it's possible to have a lot of faced situation by the origin of the Sangiovese and the origin of the wine, so at all. So I'm finishing. I want first thank you for coming. Thank you for your attention, and if you have some questions, I'm here, and all the
available to you
are here
online,
of course.
Some questions?
If not, I want to.
Jack, hi.
Yes.
Who are you with?
Marina, come here and let your and.
I have the usual. American question: are these wines available in the United States, and does anybody have any idea what their retail prices might be?
The prices, I don't
there
know.
There are the importers online, is a matter of fact. I think it's a question. Okay, hi Jack. Puoi dare la voce a Jack per cortesia?
Ecco.
We cannot hear you.
Okay, Jack.
No? Okay, there you are.
In regards to the Le Diavole, it will be arriving in the U.S. Shortly after the beginning of the year.
Okay.
So,
someone asked a question about the availability.
Michael asked.
Right, I was asking about availability and price.
I'm going to say the price. Are you asking for a wholesale or a retail price?
I don't care. I can do a calculation. So whatever you can give me.
I'm going to say a wholesale of about maybe $12 to $15 a bottle.
Yes, but the best Romagna Sangiovese are about from, I don't know, 24 to 29, 19 in wine shops, probably. I don't know if it's true for every state, of course, because it's very different in situation state by state. But to have an idea to this wine, probably Vigna delle Lepri is a little more and Diavoli is a little less, but we have about 15 to 25. This is the idea of Romagna Sangiovese in the market. But of course, it depends on the state. It depends. In California, probably is a little more because of the
Julian, you are in LA, correct?
Yes, I'm in LA. I represent Sussex. We represent Christina.
Okay, Sussex wine merchants. Okay.
And which is the price of the Zerbina Albana, for example?
In our market
In LA.
I'm actually not sure about LA, but in New York, in New Jersey, where we conduct our business, Cerezio Rosso can be found in the ballpark of $12, $13, $14 a bottle retail.
Okay.
And the Albana, Bianco di Ceparano can be found a little bit more, almost reaching $20 a bottle, depending on your address, but usually in that $16 to $18 a bottle.
Okay. So I want to tell that if you want to have a Pinot Grigio Santa Margherita in the States, it's a $25 to $30 per bottle. And so,
God bless them.
They're in the market for us.
I thought we were talking about wine, Daniele, not beverage.
Okay.
I don't know if I'm sorry, just about the price. Our retail price is for Albani crop is around $19 retail price.
Okay. Okay. Retail price.
Retail price. Yeah. It's imported in New York State from Solstar.
Okay. $9 only. $9.
Yeah. I am the importer of Noelia Ricci.
Okay.
And I can tell you that in New York, the Godenza is about 35 to 38 retail, and the regular Sangiovese Predappio is about $22 to $24.
Okay, my Godenza is a cru, so it's a top of the list, probably.
Can I ask Mauro if you're important? You're important here in the group.
So,
I work with Tredola. I'm the wine ambassador in over here in the United States with Enrico with Notturno. We have a sales retail price that varies from $16.99 to $19.99, and as far as wholesale pricing, we're roughly at $12.66 frontline and $11.33 is the deep deal.
Okay. Very, very nice price.
Yeah, very nice prices.
My compliments, Enrico. Good wines and possible to buy.
Yeah, affordable.
Affordable, yes.
Thank you.
Gianfranco Sorrentino, grazie to be with us. Ciao. I know that you are traveling snow
Gianfranco.
Everywhere.
Gianfranco, how are you? I didn't recognize you. Non ti ho riconosciuto. Dai, dai la voce a Gianfranco, sono il gruppo italiano.
Dai la voce al gruppo
Excuse
italiano.
Excuse me.
Ciao, ciao a tutti. Ciao. And I say hello from a sleepy, snowing New York. Cold, but still beautiful.
Still beautiful at all.
We know.
I miss New York, Gianfranco, really.
Looking forward to have all of you soon here in New York.
Okay.
I hope so, really. Good luck, and good luck to everybody.
Arthur, thank you. Vedi, Arthur, ricordiamo Claire in Virginia.
Yes, Virginia.
Are you in the snow or you can still walk a little bit?
No, it's just cold. Oh. We got a little bit of snow, but not a lot.
Not a lot.
But Virginia is in the south. It's not New York, it's not Boston.
A little further, yes.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you very much. Nice presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Arthur. Thank you very much.
Anything we can do, let us know.
Well,
and of course, I have to apologize for my terrible English.
No, excuse me. Wanda, did you enjoy?
Terrible English, only mine.
Okay, thank you.
Wanda, did you enjoy the presentation, the wine?
Very much. And I don't think I've ever had Albana before today. So it was a lovely introduction.
Very good.
Yeah, the Sangiovese, really, really lovely as well. Very expressive. So thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you.
Albana
thank you
is
so
a
much.
Surprise because it's a native cepage, native variety. And it's so particular of a single area. It's like, I don't know, the Chenin in Loire, it's not Sauvignon, it's not others. It's a particular area, cepage, a particular vine that owns to a region. So there are two Sangiovese you can have in different regions, also in Australia, no? Albana is only in Romagna. And this is important. And if you want, can try the sweet Albana that is incredible.
Yeah.
It's like a Mediterranean Sauternes.
Okay. Lana, thank you for being with us. Everything okay with you? Dagli la voce, per favore, Lana. Tutto sinistra, grazie.
Okay.
Okay.
Ciao. Grazie per tutti.
Grazie a te. Did you enjoy it?
I did. I didn't, I've been all over Italy. I used to live there. And I've been all over, and I didn't know about these wines. And I've been writing about Italian wines a lot this year. So I'm very happy to know about these.
Thank you very much.
And the Albana, like, it's knocked my socks off. This is what, this expression we have in the United States. I didn't know about it. And it was, I liked it a lot. It reminded me of a Semillon a little bit, with the texture and and so I really enjoyed getting to know that wine.
Thank you very much.
Yeah,
I have one thing. One thing only.
Yes.
I wanted to say, first of all, thank you for everyone for being here and happy holidays. And I believe that once the restaurant business opens again, the Gruppo Italiano in New York and throughout the United States will be holding several tastings. So we hope that Dr. Wine will be leading us to more tastings of Albana and other Italian.
We'll be there.
Of course.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
Thank you again to everyone. Despite the snow, the cold, and everything else, but thank you for being with us and following Romagna and great wines. We'll have more to come. Ruenza, vero? Ne avremo altri vini. Avremo altri vini.
Sì. Avremo altri vini e altre possibilità.
Esatto.
Grazie. Arrivederci a tutti,
ciao a tutti
e buone
happy
feste.
Holidays.
Happy holidays. Happy everything.
Bye.
Bye everyone.
Bye.
Elena.
Sì?
Sì. La risposta è sì, ok?
Ok.
Ok.
Ciao.
We're getting married. No, just kidding. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Okay. Have a holiday. I capito. I got.